Soon we will be bringing him along, and then he will be discussing, you know, more advanced issues with him in regards of what you should be doing with your training. However, if you feel that you need extra help because you're stuck somewhere, and for whatever reason you cannot contact Nicholas, and you feel that you need a session, a one-to-one online session with our market analyst, we will book an appointment for you, okay? This is going to be done over Skype. He will be telling you through your trading history where you have gone wrong, okay? What you should continue doing or what you should stop doing. We have no authority to pick up the phone or send a message to you telling you what you have to trade. Okay? This is not allowed. This is your money. It's your decision at the end of the day, and it's what you find if it's right or wrong to be done. Do we understand? Because I have a lot of clients who simply just tell me what to trade. If I knew what you were going to trade, then I'd be trading instead of you. Okay? So we're not in this position. This is our support. I will repeat, support is there to help us with everything we need. Okay? And while we're still talking about support, once you have registered your live accounts, you are kindly asked to upload your KYCs, your documents. These documents are a passport copy or your ID, colored front and back, together with proof of address. That could be anywhere between a utility bill, rental agreement, bank statement, whatever it is that you have in hand. Proof of address and no longer than 6 months old. If you have sent one in and you keep on trading, once we are near to expiry, compliance checks these things, okay, very thoroughly. You will receive an email saying that your document has expired. Please send a newer one in. Is that understood? If you have any issues with your proof of address of what you have to send, then your account manager is going to help you further on. We've talked about what Forex is. You're buying and you're selling. You buy one, you sell the other. It doesn't matter if you're buying or selling, you can still make money. Okay? But if something is going up in the market, yes, do not make the mistake and think, okay, I have to buy this because it's going up. You need to be very cautious and careful and wait a little bit, because everything that goes up has to come down again. It's only common sense. Yes? You need to be cautious when you are trading, as in using basic, very, you know, little advices that we give, but it's good that you stick with them in order for you to know that you're doing the right thing. If I'm placing a trade, I do not start opening lots. Yes? Do not expose your account, please. Do you know how much, up to how much in percentage you can expose your accounts? Somebody? You've been trading? 1% per trade. Okay. Actually, that's very,
as a beginner, you just go for microblogs. Do not expose your accounts. Please do not think that because you have put 10K in your account, you can start opening one lot after the other. You will find yourself in a difficult position. You will get stopped out, and there's nothing we can do to get the money back. You do understand we're not taking the money. This is money that's being used and traded in the market, okay? So do not expose your accounts more than 3%. Your maximum is 3%. And I have another beautiful question because I really want to hear what you're going to say. How much percent in percentage do you think you can make per month while you're trading? Let's say you deposit 1K. How much do you think you're going to be able to make per month? Somebody? I promise if you say something wrong, I'm not going to punish you. Really. I'm just trying to help you. Tell me.
40%.
Sorry?
40% of the investment.
What?
40%.
$400.
I met you yesterday. We discussed this already. Okay. Can I ask you another question? I don't remember your name.
Ahmed.
What gives you this impression that you can actually make 40%? Has somebody told you this? No. Anybody else? Our trader, your name is?
Vincent.
Vincent, what a nice name. Vincent.
How much difference you just talked to me about this collaboration?
He's so careful with his answers. He does not want to get punished. Okay. Somebody else? Okay, let me put another question. We put that one on hold. If you were to put $5,000, how much would you want to make per month? $500. Wait, he's thinking. $5,000 as your initial investment. How much do you want to make per month? What's your aim? We all have an aim in here. Yes? The thing is, can we work to the aim? Can we just get there? Because I want to be making a million every month as well, but... Smart answer. Give me an amount.
1,000.
1,000 per month. It's not bad. It's not bad. Please do not think.
I would want 5,000. Unfortunately, I don't know if I can. I would want 100%.
You want 100%.
Whether I can or not, that's something.